Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Socio Folks. Let me start by introducing myself. I am Rukmani Sharma. I work as assistant professor in Ghosh Bukhul College under North Bengal University. Today we will start with the very basic of sociology, that is the law of three stages given by Auguste Comte. And who is Auguste Comte? Auguste Comte is considered to be the father of sociology. Now you see, sociology has always been concerned with the fact of social change. But why is it so? It is because social change is pervasive and we find social change taking place everywhere in the society. And the most interesting fact of sociology is that sociology emerged at the time of profound social change. All the profound sociologists were trying to understand the social change that was taking place in the society. Whether it was Durkheim who tried to depict the transition of solidarity from mechanical to organic, whether it was Weber discussing the whole issue of rationalization and the emergence of disenchanted world, whether it was Marx trying to understand the changing class relation. There are basically four major theories of social change. First is evolutionary theory, second is functionalist theory, third is conflict theory, and the last is cyclical theory. Today we will discuss about evolutionary theory as discussed by Auguste Comte. Evolutionary theories are based on the assumption that society gradually changed from simpler beginnings to complex forms. This evolution was thought to be unilinear and progressive. Auguste Comte himself was the product of French Revolution, and the incompetence of this revolution encouraged him to produce a new science of society. Auguste Comte was highly influenced by Darwinian theory of evolution. He used this theory of evolution by Darwin to understand the evolution of human thought. He produced this law in the year 1822 in his book Positive Philosophy. He asserted that human mind is in the continuous process of change, and this has stages of development through which it has reached the present stage. His idea of law of three stages revealed that man is becoming more and more rational and scientific in their approach by gradually giving up speculations and imaginations. He has shown that there is a close association between intellectual evolution, means mental development, and social evolution, that means societal evolution. He gave three stages of development. First is theological stage, second is the metaphysical stage, and the third is the scientific stage or the positive stage. In the first stage, that is the theological stage, refers to the world prior to 1300. At this level of thinking, there is a lack of logical and orderly thinking, and human mind is dominated by sentiments, feelings, and emotions. Overall, theological thinking imposes belief in supernatural powers. According to his understanding, this type of thinking is found among the primitive races. All right? At this stage, all natural phenomena like rain, storm, earthquake, and even social events like birth, death, war, alliances were all explained in terms of supernatural forces and deities. Let me explain this by giving you an example. Suppose there is an earthquake or there is an attack by the enemy. All this were explained as the will of God. Every phenomenon was believed to be the result of the immediate action of supernatural beings. This stage is dominated by priests and ruled by military men. This is the simplest way by which you can understand the first stage, that is a theological stage. And what do you mean by theology? Theology means discourse or the study in religion. So now you know that in this stage, religion dominates. Now you see, this stage of development also has three sub-stages. And what are those? First is fetishism. Fetish means inanimate, and ism means philosophy. So this is the philosophy which believes that supernatural power dwells in inanimate objects. There was no practice of priesthood in this system. Here everything in nature is believed to have life in it, like humans, like us. For example, that could be anything like pieces of wood, stone, skull, and everything of that sort. Too many fetishes, which means too many objects to be worshipped, created confusion for people. Hence, they started believing in several gods, and this gave rise to polytheism. Now, let's understand the second stage, that is polytheism. Poly means many. So the belief in many gods is called polytheism. Okay. One god was believed to be in charge of one particular natural phenomena. For example, in Hinduism, there is wind god, fire god, sun god, goddess Ganga. Now here, people started having priests for each god to get their blessings. But again, as we know, change is inevitable. The presence of too many gods also created mental contradictions. Finally, they developed the idea of one god, that is monotheism. This is the third and last stage under theological stage. Monotheism means believe in single god. He controls everything in this world. But slowly feelings and imaginations started giving place to thinking and rationality. Now let's talk about the second stage, that is the metaphysical stage. The metaphysical stage started about 1300 AD and was short-lived, roughly till 1800. It is almost an extension of theological thinking. It represents very roughly to the Middle Ages and Renaissance. It was under the influence of churchmen and lawyers. This stage is characterized by defense. Here, mind believe in the abstract forces. Note here that the key word is forces. Supernatural being was the binding reality in the earlier theological stage is now replaced by supernatural forces. Here, being is replaced by force. Okay. Here now, if we break the term metaphysical, meta means beyond and physical means material world. Rationalism states that cause does not stand behind every social phenomena. Pure reasoning insists that God is an abstract being. Under metaphysical thinking, it is believed that an abstract power or force guides and determines the events in the world. And the last stage is the positive or the scientific stage. Finally, in 1800, the world entered the positivistic stage. The positive stage represents the scientific way of thinking. According to Auguste Comte, positive thought ushers in an industrial age. The positive or the scientific knowledge is based upon facts, and these facts are gathered by observation and experimentations. Every phenomena are seen as subject of the natural laws that can be investigated by observations and experimentations. This stage is believed to start by the dawn of 19th century. And here, what has replaced what? Here, imagination is replaced by observation. In this stage, we come to any conclusion or any generalization by collecting facts and then observing it or experimenting it very carefully, taking into consideration appropriate methodology. He thought that the concept of God will be totally vanished from human mind at this stage. Human mind tries to establish cause and effect relationship. Cause and effect relationship is very important here. This means scientific way of discovering what will be the cause or effect of any social event. This scientific thinking is thoroughly rational and there is no place for any belief or superstition in it. This stage is governed by industrial administrators and scientific temperament. So this is the ultimate stage in the series of successive transformation. But you should always remember that the assertions and the theories made by even a great scientist always have to face criticism. His law of three stages was also criticized at many levels. If you see the example of present day, we stand as a mixture of all the three stages. Some religion practice polytheism like Hinduism, and at the same time there are other religion which practice monotheism like Islam. Simultaneously, we believe to have scientific temperament. For example, while doing some action which needs high technocratic knowledge, like launching of a rocket, it is seen that the scientists make worship to the god before launching of the rocket. So our society, instead of progressing in a unilinear fashion consisting of one set of thought at a time, it is seen that it is rather an accumulation and often admixture of all the three. This is all for today. Thank you.